Hi everyone, I'm Adam McIntosh from WebSend Solutions, and welcome to our overview of time off requests for Moniroo. Now, just before we get started, let me give a quick overview of who WebSend is. We are a Microsoft Gold partner located in Toronto, Ontario, but we have operations and customers all throughout North America. We've been in business since 2000, and as you can see from the screen here, won numerous awards for our Dynamics expertise. Now, today we're going to be walking through our time off request module. This is a very simple and straightforward module, but also very powerful as well. It allows staff to request time off proactively. So this would be for things like, you know, jury duty, vacation, bereavement, so on and so forth. Those documents or those requests will automatically link to your timesheet document as well, or can be, and we'll walk through that. And then last but not least, we also have a time off calendar, so you can see when others within your department might be taking time off, and I'll show you that shortly. All right, so let's take a look. All right, so here I am in Moniroo logged in as an employee. I'm actually on the time off calendar already, and you can see here it shows in red when time has been or time off has been approved, and in yellow when there is pending time off. Now, this is just showing various employees in my demo system that are within the same department as my particular user. Every user would only have access to those staff within their department. And you can even see here Saturdays and Sundays are grayed out because those are flagged as non-working days within my company. So this is a great way to see who in your department might already be taking time off. That would probably influence when you would be able to take time off as well. So as an example, you know, maybe a lot of people take time off around Christmas, but your company still needs some staff to be working. You would want to check that calendar to see who's already got vacation approved and who doesn't. Now, to access this calendar, it's just under the timesheet module, and it's this time off calendar option. Now, within here is where you can actually create new time off requests. You can also create these from your timesheet as well, but I'll just show you it's the exact same button, exact same functionality, whether you select from within here or within your timesheet. So I'm going to show you creating a new time off request from here. So I've now opened my time off window. To create a time off request, I click this plus button. And that opens up the request at the right-hand side. Now, within this company, I've only got two options created, those being bereavement and vacation. And I'll show you where to create those later on in this video. So say I wanted to have a vacation request. I can set the start date, say April 1st. It automatically defaults the end date. If I want to set additional days, I can. So I'll go from April 1st to April 5th. And then I can just give it a description. This is free text, and I can say whatever I want. And I'll go ahead and I'll submit that. Now, one thing I should note is that you can, if you are a supervisor, set an alternate approver as you are setting your vacation request in. And you'll just have an additional button at the bottom that says whether or not you want an alternate approver, and then obviously who that would be. Now, within this window, I can also see existing time off requests if I so choose. So just using the filters here, I can search as I wish. So I can see here I previously had some time off requests. And so that's quickly, it's a quick and easy way to see, you know, some of the previous entries I have in case you're just managing your, you know, your vacation allotment for the year. So now let me go log out as this user, and I'm going to go log in as their supervisor. And I'm going to show you what the approval looks like, as well as what ends up happening with that approval. So now I'm logged in as a supervisor. I can go to my approvals. I'm going to select the time off document. And I can see here, there's document number 76 for Jessica. It's a vacation. It's for a long weekend. And she requested from the 1st to the 5th. Now, the 1st to the 5th, as you noticed on my request, was a Thursday to a Monday. And it says here the number of work days is 3. And that's because that Saturday and Sunday were flagged as non-working days. She's taking the whole day off, so it's 8 hours a day. and I can see the date submitted. So I can view any attachments or whatever she might have added to that. I can add any notes I wish, and I can approve or reject at this point. So at this point, I'm just going to simply approve it. Now, what ends up happening with that document is kind of the next question. Well, it gets added most likely to their timesheet. Now, I'll show you kind of where that's set. So under my system settings and the time off requests, I can actually see here what happens with a vacation request. So if I put in a request for the type of vacation, it gets linked to the time off grid in this situation. So the vacation tab in that time off grid. Bereavement, as an example, gets added to the sick and personal tab within that time off grid. Now, some people will link it to nothing at all and just maintain this module simply for time off because, quite frankly, they don't put in timesheets. Others will link it to that time off grid, and even others will link it to a job and task combination, that being an internal job and task combination. So it's really up to you, or up to your organization, I should say, where you want that to be linked. So in the case that it is linked to the time off or the job task option, it'll automatically create an entry on Jessica's timesheet. Okay. So this is the configuration window. Obviously, this is only available to administrators who can edit system settings. And so you can see here, you can add as many as you like. Some people will have ones for jury duty, as I mentioned off the top, tracking sick time, and other various options like unpaid leave, so on and so forth. So this is the config window for those that need access as well. So that's everything I had to show today. So just as a quick recap, the time off request module, it is a bit of a subsidiary to the timesheet module. Those documents do link to the timesheets if you so choose. It uses the standard workflows in the system. As you saw there, I had the manager approve Jessica's timesheet. And what's really handy, I should say, is that calendar view. So you can see when others in the organization are going to be out of office and have current requests in. So thanks for joining us today. If you have any questions about the module or want that to be installed on your Moniroo environment, feel free to reach out to our team at info@websand.com. If you like this video, please like on our YouTube channel and subscribe to that same YouTube channel as we publish more great content. Thanks.